Tomorrow marks the 9th anniversary of the Hallam, Nebraska tornado. That was an EF4.
And the damage left behind is remarkably similar to what we're seeing in Oklahoma. Understandably, it brings back plenty of memories for those who lived through it.
KETV News Watch 7's Ryan Luby, just back from Hallam tonight. He continues our team coverage live.
And Brandy, the tornado there was 2.5 miles in width, technically a little wider than the one we saw yesterday down in Moore, Oklahoma. It killed a woman. You can see that it took out nearly the entire town. And yes, tonight in Hallam, it's not easy to look back.
Typically, it's nice to take a trip down memory lane, but in this corner of Tornado Alley, in small town Hallam, most here could do without. But most cannot forget.
Was there a house here in the corner?
There had been. A huge home.
This is Laura Edmonds' corner.
We have a lot of great vacant lots with new infrastructure underneath it.
Laura says roughly a quarter of Hallam's people never returned. One look at the damage in 2004, and it's easy to see why some wanted to move on. So to see similar destruction 9 years later, almost to the day, she relives the pain and remembers how it felt.
I can't remember what we said other than stammering because it's overwhelming. Your senses, all of your senses are in overload.
Well, no doubt everybody here in Hallam had a flashback to 2004. That's especially true for a man who not only lost his home, but also lost his business that he's since rebuilt.
It looked real familiar. It sure did.
Joe Polak reflects less on images of destruction, more on people.
I feel for them folks down there. You know, it's just starting for them.
And he says for him, it never seems to go away.
It psychologically messed people up.
So even though the town has rebuilt with new homes and new trees, this trip down memory lane this night is like remembering a bad day as if it really were yesterday.
Now the Hallam tornado still remains as the widest tornado ever, again, 2.5 miles wide. Rob, Randy, back to you.
Ryan, thanks. Tragic.